Hello everyone, this is Rajiv Kohli and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. And in this tutorial I will show you how to create this Wolverine character animation in PowerPoint 2016. So have a look first. And this time I also added some audio files to create the impression. And I hope you will like this tutorial. So let's get started. And first of all, I would like to tell you that this animation is inspired from one of the pen by Lux at codepen.io website. So this animation also has a mouse over effect here. The claws of the X-Men comes out when I move my mouse over it. And this animation is also further inspired from one of the art by Georgie Hartman at dribble.com. You can see his work right here. So, taking the inspiration from this character, I drew the same character here in PowerPoint using the shape tools. And you can watch one of my tutorial series on how to use shape tools in Microsoft Word, and the same procedure is used in PowerPoint as well. The link of that playlist is given in the description below. So, before I show you the animation, that how to apply animation to this character here, let me show you the objects that I have used to create this character here. And these are the list of the objects. And you can open the selection pane from the home tab by clicking the select drop down button and then choose selection pane. And here you can see all the objects that I have used. So each group indicates that it is a separate object. Like this left leg is a separate object and this right leg is a separate object. So you have to take care of this thing very carefully, that which object should be separate from rest of the body. That is because in PowerPoint 2016 you still can't apply two different animation to a grouped object. That is why you have to take care that which objects will be separate from the resting objects. So here if you take a look at the animation, then you can see that head is moving, the neck and the shield is moving, and left and right hands are also moving up and down. So here in my animation, what I did here is, along with the head, body and hands, I also give a little bit rotation to the hands here. And you can also note down an animation in the eyes. The eyes blinks and later it's also shrink a little bit. So that is what I am going to teach you here. So let's get started, and let me open the animation pane first. So for that, go to the animations tab and click animation pane. And here I will delete all these animation first by selecting the first one, then hold down the shift key and then select the last one. Hit the delete key from the keyboard. So the first animation that I will apply will be on head. So I will select the head, go to the add animation drop down button and go to more motion paths. Here apply the up motion path, hit the OK key and then adjust the path length. So I want to apply a very little path here, very short path here. So I will select the head and will zoom in by holding the control key and then use your middle mouse button to zoom into the selected object. So here I will select this path and will drop it right here. And we'll set it to play with previous with a duration of 2 seconds. Open the effect options window by double clicking on the effect. And here I will apply auto reverse. Go to the timings tab and here set it to repeat until end of the slide. Hit the OK key. Let's see the slideshow. And our head is moving now. As you can see, the eyes are separate from the head. That is because I want to apply another animation on the eyes, along with the up down effect, that is the blinking effect, and for that I will use the grow shrink effect. So that is why eyes are separate from the head, because you can't apply separate animations to the grouped objects. Now I am going to select this head, go to the animations tab and use the animation painter to copy the same effect over the eyes, and for that click animation painter once and then click on the eyes. and the eyes will now start moving up and down along with the head. So we will use the same technique on the rest of the objects that we want to move here, because same animations has been used on all the objects. So I zoom out a little bit. Now I select the head again, double click the animation painter, that will lock the animation painter, and you can apply the same head animation to rest of the objects by just clicking on them. And finally on the shield. So here we have applied all the main animation, that is moving the objects up and down. So let's see the slideshow first. And here I will make a little bit changes, and those are, first of all I will add a delay timing to the left hand, and that will be around 0.10 seconds. And then to the neck and shield, I want to move this shield with a little bit delay than the head. So I am adding a 0.20 second delay to the neck and shield. Move ahead and will apply a spin animation to the left hand, and for that I select the left hand, go to the add animation, apply spin animation, set it to play with previous, open the effect option window, and here I will apply a 10 degree rotation clockwise with auto reverse, and I would also like to repeat this animation until end of the slide. So let's see the slideshow again. So now the hand is moving up and down, and along with that it is also spinning at 10 degree clockwise, and the same animation will be applied on the right hand. So I select the right hand, go to add animation, spin, set it to play with previous, open the effect option window, set it to rotate at 10 degree counterclockwise, auto reverse, and repeat until end of the slide. So the next thing is, you can also arrange the animations like that. You can hold down the animation from the animation pen and can just drag and drop it right here. So it will be easy for you to note down the animation in the list when they are closer together. So here I would like to clarify one thing here. If you see the class of this X-Men here, and let me move this hand first, and here you can see these glass, but the area of this glass, you can see that it is larger than the glass. That is because it is the same object here, the left hand, the complete left hand with glass. What I just did is I just hide the hand here by removing the fill color. If I use a fill color here, then you can see rest of the hand here. So why I did this, let me show you. So I will also open selection pane here to select the objects easily. So as you can see in the animation, that hands are moving up and down and also spinning along with that. So I want to apply the same animation to the claws. So for that, what you have to do here, I will hide all the objects here, and first of all I will bring the left hand with claws, and that is left class only. So I will select the left hand, click the animations tab, click animation painter, and now hide this left hand claw, and then just click on the class. So that way it will be easy for you to replicate the animation on the class. And I am hiding these objects because that class are behind almost all the objects. That is why it will be difficult to apply the animation painter on the class alone. That is why I use this selection pane to hide the objects that I don't require. So using the same method, I will select the right hand. Here I will hide all of them, right hand with class, and then right hand class only. So I select the right hand, click animation painter, and then hide this class right hand, and then apply the animation on this. Now bring all the objects back and see the slideshow. Now the glass will also move along with the hands. So that was the technique I used to copy the same effect on the claws. So what I need now is to bring the claws at a specific time. And for that, I will select the left claws only, add animation and apply appear animation, set it to play with previous, and then take this animation in the list and put it on top of the left claws animation. And here I will add a delay timing of 2 seconds. And I also want to bring the claws in an animation. And for that I will use wipe animation and will set it to from right, I think. Yes, from right. Set it to play with previous and put it also below this animation, the appear animation. So now what will happen? You will not see the claws at the first place when you will see the slideshow. The claws will come forward at the time of 2 seconds and then they will show all these animations. That's right. So I am going to apply the same technique on the right claws, and for that I will select the right hand claws only. And here again I will apply the appear effect, set it to play with previous with a duration of 2.10 seconds, a little bit more delay than the left hand claws. And then again I will apply the wipe animation to right claws as well, set it to play with previous, and they will come from, I think, left. Yes, from left. So let's see the slideshow. There is a mistake here. So I think I have to put these on top of these animations and set the delay timing 2.10. Now let's see the animation. That's right. So now I want to hide these claws. So for that I will select the left claw and right claw and go to add animation and apply wipe animation again, set it to play with previous and add a delay timing when you want to hide these claws again. And for that I will apply 7 second timings. I think 6 will be enough. So let's see what happened. Coming out. Yes, going away. You can add a little bit delay here. For the left claw, I want to hide it a bit later. That's right. Now I will apply the animation to the eyes, and for that I select the eyes alone and go to the add animations drop down button, apply grow shrink, set it to play with previous, and I want to add a delay timing of 1.80 seconds and a duration of 0.25 seconds. I want to apply the shrink effect vertically only, and I also want to auto reverse this effect with the shrink rate to 10%. Hit the OK key. Now let's see the animation. That's right. I want to apply another animation on the eyes and again grow shrink, set it to play with previous, and this time duration will be 1.75 seconds and a delay timing of 5 seconds. Open the effect option window, set it to auto reverse, and I want to shrink this time to 50% only with more duration timing. Hit the OK key. I want to apply this effect as well, vertically only. So finally we will add the audio here, and for that I will use an audio file that I downloaded from YouTube, and for that click the insert, audio on my PC, and that Wolverine Claws file, insert. Hide during show, that will hide this icon, this audio icon, when you will see the slideshow. So you can check this out. Click the animations, open animation pane and set this audio file to play with previous. Now I will drag this audio file near to the left claw. So let's see the animation. Okay, now I want to trim the audio because that is a 8 or 9 second video, and for that I go to the playback section, click trim audio, and here I will use that part of the audio. Hit the OK key. Now let's see the slideshow again. Okay, that's fine. Now again insert the same file. Set it to hide during show and place it right here. Go to trim audio, and this time I will use this sound. Or I maybe from here to right here. Now see the slideshow. Let me set it to play with previous, and that should play right at this time. Now see the slideshow. That's fine. So I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by leaving your valuable comments in the section below. And don't forget to hit the like button and do share this video with your friends. Thanks for watching and have a nice day.